But it's, you know, it's hard to recreate it the next day, different environment, different conditions. I knew it was there. It's just a matter of, you know, a lot of times when you PR, your body kind of shuts down, which happened to me in 2015. I PR'd, and the next day my body said,
not gonna do
it. So being able to come back and get close to it, you know, that's the second fastest time I've ever ran besides yesterday. So to come back, peak at the right time, at a big stage, not just a small meet, really means a lot.
Yeah, how did the experience, like going to the World Relays? I was down in Nassau, and you were the captain of the team. And have you run there the year before?
Yes, sir. I was lead leg both 2 years in a row.
Right. So, you know, what did that kind of experience, how does that sort of stuff carry over for individual races?
Yes, sir. I was on the relay in 2013, then both world relays, indoor relay. So it puts you in the mix, you know, it gets you on a big stage. It gets you to, you know, kind of focus your thoughts, relax. You know, I'm not coming out here being like, oh my gosh, I've never seen these things before, never seen a big crowd. So it really helps, you know, doing those events early. To come to a stage like USA Trials, which is the hardest team to make, and, you know, kind of relax your mind and just get it done, we have to get done.
Well, and then you've got veterans on the team at Nassau, like Warner, you know, and folks like that, that, you know, I mean, that's got to be just being around them. You absorb that
knowledge. I remember sitting at home watching both Rashawn's and Warner's races over and over again on YouTube, trying to learn as much as I can about the 400. They're the two best runners that are from the U.S. that I've ever ran. So watching their races, learning how to run, when I'm with them on teams, talking to them, like, how do you focus? So they're competition, but at the end of the day, I'm the new cat on the block, so trying to learn as much as I can from them so I can carry it forward.
Well, and they'll share it too, because they're, you know, quality guys, and they no doubt see you as the next generation.
They are first-rate athletes, first-class gentlemen. If I have a question, they will tell me. You know, it's real, we're competitive on the track. You know, everyone wants to beat everybody, but off the track, you know, jack each other up, shake hands. Good job, man. Congrats. And we help each other out. So it's really it's not a team sport, but it's at the same time.
Yeah.
Coming down that final stretch, was there kind of a mental block to beating LeSean? I mean, you finally did it, but what was going through your head? And what does it mean to finally beat him?
You know, because anytime you're with LeSean Mary, it's like, you know, you want to go, but at the same time, it's like, it's him, so I'm not supposed to beat him type of thing. He had a step on me, and I was about to settle and be like, you know what, I'll take second place. This is still a huge accomplishment for me. And then something clicked in my head and said, you know what, just go for it, see what happens. It wasn't the prettiest finish. My head was thrashing, teeth were grit. I was fighting, but I was able to come away with a win.
So but you're not going to give up and not try.
I've never been known to give up.
No.
So that thought was out of there, so I had to go for it.
Well, it was great. You'll see on the screen, you had Norwood on the left-hand side of the screen. You're right, and then LeSean, two much bigger guys. There's this little squirt in the middle, man, beating them both.
You know, I'm not the tallest guy out there by any means. I'm probably one of the shortest, but I've always run with heart, even through college, so I might not be the tallest one, but I have the most heart.
Well, you run big, I mean, long strides, even with shorter legs.
I'd normally large stride for my size, so it plays an advantage to have a quick turnover, too. So somehow the good Lord decided for it to click with me. So
what are you, about 5'8", 5'9"?
5'7".
5'7", sorry about that. All right.
Okay. What did you guys say to each other after the race?
Oh, we said congrats. I didn't really talk, so I was still kind of speechless. I congratulated Norwood. He had a great season. I know he's been winning it. Congratulated LeSean. And other than that, I was just kind of still looking at the clock and kind of disbelief, waiting for it to switch, and they messed up.
So you thought, did you really think maybe you had not won?
I thought for a second he edged me out, and I got a second. I knew it was close. You know, a lot was going on. And then I saw my name up first. I was in disbelief. I can't lie.
Well, that's awesome. You earned it. So
your name's always been. What's next between now and Worlds?
Apparently, I just found out from my agent I'm supposed to go to Paris in a couple of days. We're going to talk about that one. It's been a long week here. But now it's just go back to the weight room, go back to training, and make sure we're sharper than I was here for Beijing.
Training where?
I trained in Gainesville, Florida with Mike Holloway.
All right. Well, he knows one or two things about the 400.
He produces, you know, 400 runners all the time, 200 runners. He's a great coach.
400 you, yeah.
He's a great coach, and I was blessed to be a part of his training camp, and it's paid off.
Yeah, it's great. Congratulations.